ladies and gentlemen, the following contest. It is set for one fall. The winner to meet Nature Boy Ric Flair for the WCW Heavyweight Championship at Spring Stampede. Introducing first from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 236 pounds, Ricky the Dragon.
See the sign, Ricky is breathing fire. It's his shot at Ric Flair, a shot that he claims that he should have anyway. Of course, we have seen on this program the... Watch out.
Oh, yikes! I can feel the heat here.
We've seen on this program the plea by Colonel Rob Parker. And this match is set to go in our main event as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this one fall event. He'll be led to the ring by the greatest promoter on the face of the earth, Robert Parker. He's from Hollywood, California. He weighs 253 pounds. The United States Heavyweight Champion, Stunning Steve Austin!
Oh yeah!
The U.S. Champion and Ricky Steamboat are set to go. The match in its entirety when Saturday night continues after this.
For hours you've been taking your tickets and can't take them anymore. Since Twix gives you chewy caramel twice, milk chocolate twice, and that cookie crunch twice, you get one great snack.
Will you tell me when my mom gets here?
After another.
For 94 Flair Baseball, it's a whole new ballgame with even more quality and collectability. We've got a hot new look with gold foil stamping on each card and UV coating on both sides. We're covering all the bases with 11 new insert sets, seated one card per pack. And we're bringing home extra excitement with the all-rookie team exchange card. It's one unbelievable card set. 1994 Flair Baseball, a game in every pack.
Debbie, these shots are fabulous. Beautiful, Debbie.
Better than the last time, Tony?
Absolutely.
It's my job to make sure people look good. A few weeks ago, while doing test shots with Debbie, I noticed something. Dandruff. So I told her about Head & Shoulders. You see, regular shampoos merely rinse flakes away, so they could come back. But look, Head & Shoulders helps stop flakes from even forming. You see the difference?
Yeah, picture perfect.
Head & Shoulders turns dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
Don't worry. We'd never leave you in the dark. Experience Milky Way dark.
Only one children's vitamin has the fun shapes and great Flintstones taste kids love.
We are Flintstones kids. 10 million stars.
Flintstones, complete with the vitamins and minerals kids need.
Happy anniversary to my bride of 32 years.
Get well soon. I hate gossiping alone.
Happy birthday, sis. You're at a great age, older than me.
A special thanks to a client who makes business a pleasure.
I'm sorry. Am I still in the doghouse?
When you want to send your best wishes with flowers, call us and we'll make all the arrangements. 800 flowers. Just call our name.
Nick Van Exel meets Carl Malone, Lakers, Jazz, Monday at 9 Eastern, then Tuesday, Shaq in Bay, Chicago, Magic, Bulls, Tuesday at 8 Eastern,
on TNT.
Mm-hmm.
The bell sounds. We are back on Saturday night. So much at stake during this matchup, Brain, between Steamboat and Stunning Steve. And you got to realize, got to know, both men are prepared.
Well, you know, for Steamboat, this is making or breaking. You know, it might be a while before he gets another shot. The way there's so much competition here right now. He's in line, and Steamboat's going to take advantage of it. But then again, so is Stunning Steve Austin. Because the Colonel is not going to let an opportunity like this slip through his fingers.
Side headlock to the ropes on the left side. Steamboat trying to fight his way out of that predicament there. His back is against the ropes, a place he doesn't want to be, and there's one. He got a shot breaking out, and that's exactly what Stunning Steve wanted.
I hope Austin is focused on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. I hope he's not thinking ahead to Stampede and the Nature Boy Ric Flair, because that could cost him the match.
Well, on Dragon Twist, sending Steamboat right down to one knee. Well, we heard the comments from Hulk Hogan, and hey, you were there. You asked the burning question, didn't you?
Oh, was that right? Oprah walked around praising him about, oh, you're such a great movie star. Look at the beautiful beach. What a great series, blah, blah, blah. I went right into the trench. I went right into the camel's breath. I asked him. I rolled my sleeves up. I got dirty. I said, hey, big man, you tell me the story right here. And I got the answers. I got backbone.
Steamboat, side headlock. Well, some interesting comments from the Hulkster, and I...
And you see him put his hand on me? He pushed me with two fingers. Boy, he's lucky I had that sports coat on.
Is he now? Side headlock applied by Steamboat. Hopefully, maybe in the weeks to come, we'll get a comment from Ric Flair about what we've just heard. But Flair, like all of us, certainly has to be watching this one. The winner to face Flair at Spring Stampede at the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago. Side headlock, shooting Steamboat in, hooks on. The crucifix, Steamboat trying to hang on to the rope, but no. Again, takes him over. Solid wrestling match for Steamboat so far.
Well, there's so much at stake here. I mean, either one of these two great athletes here could be in the ring with Flair. See, Flair's got it easy. All he's got to do is sit back and relax. Each one of these competitors have to go out there and beat the other guy, then come and beat Flair in April. That's not an easy task.
Well, it's easy for Flair right now, but it's not going to be easy April 17th, exclusively on pay-per-view.
Well, they got to beat Flair. You don't have to beat them. But Flair's not that kind of a wrestler. He don't lay back. He don't let you come to him. He'll take it right to you.
Side headlock takeover. Steamboat holding on. Steamboat content with keeping Stunning Steve on the mat.
Well, that's a smart thing to do. Anytime you get in a fight, keep him on the mat. I remember one time I had my cousin down. I must have had her down for 10 or 15 minutes before she gave up. But she was a year older.
Your cousin? Female?
You know her?
No.
Oh, she's tough. Toughest cheerleader at Beverly Hills High. So I straighten her out.
Austin down for two and bridges out of it. Steamboat. But look at this. Look at Steamboat. Counters, takes him over side headlock. Great wrestling by the Dragon.
It's like the spin cycle on a washing machine.
I guess it is. Hey, did you hear the comments from Oakland early about the new love for Sting?
Sting has a new love?
That's what he said.
Can only mean one thing. He bought another mirror.
He will have more of that on the hotline tonight until midnight. You know, I want to remind the fans that I'm on the hotline as well on Tuesday night.
Oh, I've heard some of the things you've said about me. You know, Oakland's never liked you, you know. He hates you. He told me that.
Oakland feels that.
He feels that way about you. I've always liked you, though, Tony.
Side headlock hooked on. I don't believe that. There you see our great fans encouraging Steamboat to clamp it in tighter.
Have you noticed they haven't really all gone out yet? You know what I mean? I mean, they're both laying back. Believe me, Steamboat doesn't want to hold him in that headlock, but that's the best move he's got right now.
Ducking. Crossbody block. Austin turns him over, gets a two only. Oh, Steamboat barely kicked out on that one. Austin had him hooked, and Steamboat came away. Now head first. Now they're opening up a little bit here, Bobby.
Well, Well, they've got to now. Time's important. And they know Flair's watching. You know that, too.
Into the jaw. Conditioning, such a big part of our sport. And you are looking at two of the best in the sport right now as far as conditioning are concerned.
Oh!
Big tap! Steamboat takes him down again. It's Steamboat who keeps the fight on the mat here. Once again, fans, the winner faces Ric Flair. Spring Stampede world title will be on the line that night. We will come to you Sunday, April 17th, live from the Rosemont Horizon.
Chi-Town.
You know, they don't like for you to call it Chi-Town, people in Chicago.
I don't care what they like or dislike. If they were any kind of fans, they wouldn't wear blue and C's and yell for the Cubs, who've never won a game. Bears are doing great, huh?
Anybody else real quickly here?
Well, we can talk about the waste. Well, I could talk about Chicago all day long, but why waste my time? I'm the one that made Chicago famous.
You?
Yes.
How did you make Chicago famous?
Hang around with me when we get there. I'll show you.
All right. All right, I will, Brain. Back up now, though.
Chi-Town, my kind of town.
Steamboat. Hangs onto that side headlock. Austin wants to get those high-impact blows in there, but Steamboat hooks on. Steamboat has become one of the greatest wrestlers in the world through wrestling. But he can also go up top, usually by his own accord.
Martial arts.
He has it all. And I think has the experience advantage here over Stunning Steve, even though being the U.S. champion, like Steve has been, being a world television champion for 18 months, the longest in the history of our sport, like Austin was, gives you a great deal of experience also. But he's still a youngster. And he's going up against one of the masters. He's got him caught on the top rope. There you see Nick Patrick. Oh, he's laying him in now.
He's got to be very careful here, Shivani, that he doesn't get disqualified.
Right.
The last thing you want is to blow an opportunity at the World Championship because you didn't keep a cool head.
Stomping on the chest. Steamboat in trouble. Head was resting on that bottom turnbuckle. And now Stunning Steve with the abdominal stretch.
He does have Hawaiian blood in him, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
I can smell the pineapple juice from here. I think that's pineapple juice.
Nick Patrick, and you hear Colonel Rob Parker.
Well, the Colonel's got a right to cheer. He's got a right to pace the sideline.
Yes, he does. As you see, Stunning Steve holding the rope for leverage on the far side.
He's holding his hip. He's not holding the rope.
No, I think Bobby was holding the rope
for his own balance. That's all right, isn't it?
No, it's not. It's illegal.
Back to the sick bird, huh?
It's not within the rules. And again, there you see it. Good work.
See, that doesn't put any added pressure on the hole. It just keeps Steamboat from getting out of it.
Steamboat firing back on it. Staggers the U.S. champion. And he was going in for a big chop.
Whoa.
My goodness.
Come on, Steve, cover him!
Look at the instinctive move of Steamboat to get to his feet. Look at that.
Wow.
Tremendous move by Stunning Steve. It's amazing Steamboat can even stand after that. He's in a lot of pain, though, Brain. But look at him. And Austin laying him in. Steamboat right now can't even fight him off. Look at him. Oh my!
This isn't going to do Austin any good. He's got to get him back in that ring to beat him.
Oh yeah, but that is.
Well, that won't hurt.
Steamboat on one knee. Watch out! Don't want to count out here. Count out would give Stunning Steve the title shot.
But he knows that he's got to get him back into that ring. He can't beat him on the floor.
Steve measuring the dragon. Steamboat trying to pull himself up now. Look at Steamboat fire back. You talking about heart and determination. Steamboat's got it all. Look at him again. Steamboat. Oh, no. He opened himself up that time, Brain.
Oh, he certainly did. He came over right in the middle of the rope. I wouldn't have done that. Almost got a three there.
Stunning Steve, I think, since his victory. He is now focusing on the ribcage after that fling to the mat, after Colonel Parker had his cheap shot on the floor. He's going right to the ribcage now with the bear hug.
Well, it's obvious to me that Parker and Austin have a plan. And the plan is to take care of the dragon here and go on to Chicago.
The chant of Steamboat. The dragon. Oh, he tried to chop his way out of it, but he was cinched it up even tighter. Boy, Austin, the U.S. champ, one of the greatest in our sport. Hooking on a legend in his own right, Ricky Steamboat.
And he's a young man.
Yes, he is.
I mean, to be the United States champion this soon. Also, at one time, he was world tag team champion.
And world television champion. Longest time in the history of WCW, 18 months.
Well, there's only one title left, isn't there?
It sure is, and he'll get the shot if he wins this matchup. Steamboat fighting out. He broke loose. Steamboat head of steam. Shoulder block takedown. And again, here he goes for a third time. Austin ducks low and catches him with a knee.
He had to do that. I was hoping he'd do that, or at least hit him from behind in the lower kidney area.
But Steamboat.
You gotta stay on Steamboat.
Look at Steamboat fight.
You can't give him an inch.
Austin hooks on. What a match we got going here. Wait a minute. Is that a disqualification? Austin's out. Colonel Parker's up.
I believe Steamboat threw him over the top, didn't he?
The match, he's got him rolled up. Turn around, Nick Patrick. One, two.
No, no, no. What is it?
Two count. Nick Patrick telling Colonel Parker to stay down. Double chop, cover again. Do it.
Oh, he didn't get it. Come on, Colonel, do something.
They are standing everywhere here. One man will go on to Chicago.
No, he won't get him that way.
And a chop. Where he gets his reserve from, I don't know.
This is it. It's going in Austin's favor now. But he keeps coming back, Giovanni. Look at the fight in Steamboat.
He knocked Austin down. And Austin sends him on the outside. Now a count out here will give Austin.
Oh.
Down goes Colonel Parker. Steamboat. Colonel's holding the arms.
Steamboat. Come on, ref.
He got out of it. Two. Steamboat escaped again.
Come on, ref.
This is incredible. He rolls him up again.
No, no, no.
Can you believe it? They're still going at it. One, two.
No. Steamboat's gone about 15 times now. Taking him to the well, but he can't do it. He can't pin Austin.
Who can get the backslide? Who's got the extra added?
Drop to your knees, Austin. Come on.
They're literally hooked up. Parker's in. Steamboat's gonna win it. Steamboat will win it by disqualification.
No, wait a minute. How do you know that?
Here comes Ric Flair. Oh my! He hit Ric Flair.
Oh, here we go.
Flair came in and Steamboat chopped him down.
Sure, now he's trying to butter up the champ, but he tried to take a cheap shot on him. That's the way I see it.
And Flair's hot about it.
Of course he's hot about it.
He came in to help it out. We haven't got the official word yet. Steamboat will go on to Chicago, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match to meet Nature Boy Ric Flair for the heavyweight championship is Ricky the Dragon.
Flair came in to help him.
And Flair's unhappy.
Of course he's unhappy.
All right, fans, we'll be back with more on Saturday.